On the bell work for today, what you want to do is put a dot where the angle is. So in this case, the angle's up here. So put your dot up there. Put a dot on the box, and that represents the two legs. So this is a leg, and this one is a leg, and the other one is called the hypotenuse. Now, this is x. If you're standing right here, this side is actually the opposite. So let's change that to opposite. This one would be the adjacent. So now you have it labeled, and let me put some numbers in here. All right, we're looking for an A and an H. So an A and an H, you have so, ka, toa, and A and an H is cosine. So it should be the cosine of 50 degrees is equal to adjacent over the hypotenuse. Any questions on what I said or what I did so far? If you didn't do well on the trig test, learn it and then let me know a day in advance, excuse me, and I'll print up another test. Anyway, what I'm going to get here is 20 times this. Put a 1 under here if you want. So 1 times x is x. So the answer is going to be 20 times the cosine of 50 degrees. And we might as well finish it up. So press 50, cosine, and then times 20. So what I get here is I get 12.9, it looks like. Any questions on how to do the trig? Again, this is a review. All right, there are other videos. You don't have to look at mine. There's tutoring in the guidance office as well. All right, look up here. This one says find the area. The formula's on the board, but here it is. Area is equal to 1/2 A times B times the sine of the included angle. Included angle. And then that's basically it. So all you're going to do here is multiply this times the sine of this and divide by 2. So watch. 9 times 20 times the sine of the included angle divided by 2. Now you might say, well, where did this one come from? On the worksheet from yesterday, and let me just video it real quick. The ones on the back were following that second one that I just did, right here where it says find the area. So for example, on number 25, if I can zoom in, all you do is multiply this times the sine of this angle. So 11 times 11 times the sine of the angle divided by 2. And that's the way you work this whole bottom part. Now some of you were confused with the top part. All right, so look up here at the top part. Pay attention now, okay, because if you want to get credit, you're going to have to show me the work. What you need to do is first draw a triangle and label it ABC. So right now, I want everybody, even if you did number 11, I want you to draw this triangle, please. Now across from the big A is going to go the little A. Thank you. Across from the big B is going to go the little B. So across from the big A is going to go the little A. Across from big B, little B, across from big C, little C. Any questions on how to draw that triangle or how to label it? It's just a generic triangle. Now, let's put the information in there. They say A, or angle A, is 70, so put 70 degrees. They tell you that C is 26, so put 26. And then they tell you that A is 25, so put 25. Now, they want you to find everything. See right here? It says solve. Now, I didn't make you do this, and I wasn't quite clear on the directions yesterday, but they wanted you to find everything, all right? So if you do it today to finish it up, just find one thing. But let me show you how to do it. All right, to do it, I have a pair right here. I have an angle and a side. An angle and a side. That's a pair. And then here, I have a side, but no angle. So I'm going to put an X here for the angle. I'm going to find that first. So the formula is the sine of the angle, which is 70 degrees, divided by the opposite side. I'm going to say it again. The sine of the angle, which we don't know, divided by the opposite side. This is called the law of sines. All right, there's two of them, but this is the one you use. So what we're going to do is this. Watch and listen. I'm going to multiply by 26, and then I'm going to divide by the word sine. So when I multiply by 26, I get 26 times the sine of 70 divided by 25. And then when I divide by the word, it becomes the inverse sine. When you divide by the word sine. And that gives you the angle. So angle X is equal to that. Now some of you might be looking at it like, man, I understood how you set it up, but I don't understand how to solve it. And that's a fair response, okay? So maybe you didn't understand what I did in my head. So let me show you. If you understood the proportion, then all you do is multiply this times 26 times the sine of 70 equals 25 times the sine of angle X. That's the first thing you do. You're trying to get X by itself. So you're going to divide both sides by 25 and the word sine. 25 and the word sine. This cancels. So you get angle X is equal to. Now, the word sine right here is going to move up to the top. You cannot cancel these out, so don't try that. But when this sine is a 1 right here, when this sine moves up to the top, it becomes the arc sine of all of this. So 26 times the sine of 70 divided by 25. I don't know if that made it more complicated to explain it that way. I wouldn't do it that way, but Dustin, I know that some people need to see it that way. Maybe it will help. I don't know. But when you work all of this out, you get the angle. Then you subtract from 180, and you get the upper angle. And they wanted you to find all the missing sides and all the missing angles, which is a lot of work. But if you at least show me some work, I'll give you some credit. All right, let's talk about today's work now. We're going to talk about polygons and interior angle theorem. So draw a line on a new sheet of paper, not on your Bellwork. A polygon is a closed figure. Let's say it again. A polygon is a closed figure. So a triangle is a polygon. The fence around your yard, if the gate is closed, is a polygon. Now, what is not a polygon? No curves. So put no curves. So if you have a figure like this, with a curve, it's not a polygon. If you have a figure like this, where it's not shut, like you left the gate open and the dog got out, okay, that is not a polygon. A polygon is a closed figure. Now, there are two types of polygons. One is called concave, and one is called convex. Okay? And they're going to ask you this on the EOC. All right, so here we go. Concave and convex. Concave, it's kind of like if you live up north and you get a lot of snow and the roof collapses. Okay, not a good day. All right, that's why you see people up there shoveling the snow off their roof, because it's heavy. And if it's too heavy, it could collapse. All right, that would be concave. Convex would be like all the points are pointing outward. That would be convex. It's kind of like if you take a paper bag and you blow in it, it puffs out. That would be convex. Concave basically is what the word is. It caves in. Is everybody clear on what I'm saying between concave and convex and what a polygon is and what a polygon is not? All right, anyway, what we're doing is interior angle measure. Now, to do that, let me basically go over what today's lesson is going to be on. So draw this polygon. It has six sides. Does anybody know what a six-sided polygon is called? It's called a hexagon. All right, very good. What is a four-sided polygon called?
Square.
Could be a square.
Rectangle.
It's actually called a quadrilateral because it's got four sides. It could be a rectangle. Absolutely. But the word is quadrilateral. What is a five-sided figure called?
Pentagon.
Pentagon. An eight-sided figure?
Octagon.
Octagon. A stop sign is an octagon. Does anybody know what a seven-sided figure is?
No.
Starts with an S or an H? Septagon or heptagon? Either one. How about a ten-sided figure?
Tenagon.
Deca, like decade. All right, look up here. Put a dot right here on this vertex or vertice. Now let's draw some triangles. You have one triangle here, one triangle here, and one triangle here. How many triangles do you see?
Four.
There are four triangles. And how much is each triangle worth?
180.
So put 180. Is everybody with me so far? Clear your calculator. Take 180 times 4 and tell me what the interior angle. How much? 5 what? 720. So it's 720 degrees total. Now what that means is this. I want you to look up here so you know. That means if I add up this angle, this angle, this angle, this angle, this angle, and this angle, it adds up to 720 degrees. That's called the shell method, is what I call it. It looks like a shell. It's not really called that, but to me it looks like it. Anyway, here's the formula. Interior angle measure is n minus 2 times 180. Write that down. It's on the ELC. Memorize it. N minus 2 times 180. The N represents the number of sides. So a hexagon has how many sides?
Six.
So put 6 minus 2 times 180. Guess what 6 minus 2 is?
Four.
Four triangles. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's four triangles, which gives you 720. So you could do the shell method if you forget the formula, but you need to memorize this formula. All right, next. Let's draw an octagon. Okay? Now, I know a lot of people don't like that, but I kind of like watching those octagon fights. Okay? It's kind of brutal, but anyway, let's draw an octagon. Draw an octagon. And maybe make it look better than mine. This is a stop sign. So if you rolled the stop sign this morning, you want to stop rolling the stop sign. All right. An octagon has how many sides?
Eight
sides. All right, well, mine's kind of messy, so.
No, mine's
like. See, what you forgot was, you got the, yeah, it's okay.
I'm
not even going to touch it.
Okay.
All right, write down the formula. N minus 2 times 180.
You want us to plug in N or different?
No, write down the formula. So put N minus 2. times 180. And how many sides do we have for an octagon?
8.
So put 8 minus 2 times 180. So what's 6 times, is it 1080 or something? I don't know. What's 6 times 180?
1080.
All right, 1080 degrees. All of the interior angles will add up to 1080 degrees. Let's see if there's anything else I need to teach you. I don't think so. All right, that's it. This is going to take you through. It's going to be a lot, but they're easy. So don't panic. If I have to, I'll adjust it. I want 749, and I want you to try to get up to 757. Just try and do what you can. Make sure you draw the diagrams. Thank you.